Good day everyone! In this video, we will be discussing about evaluating trigonometric expressions using the sum and difference identities. The following are the known sum and difference identities. Sine alpha plus minus beta is equal to sine alpha cosine beta plus minus cosine alpha sine beta. This formula means that if we have two angles, alpha and beta, and we need to find the sine of alpha plus beta, that will be equal to sine alpha cosine beta plus cosine alpha sine beta. Now, if we will to find sine alpha minus beta, then that will be equal to sine alpha cosine beta minus cosine alpha sine beta. Moreover, the second pair of identities are cosine alpha plus minus beta is equal to cosine alpha cosine beta minus plus sine alpha sine beta. Meaning, if we will to find cosine alpha plus beta, then that will be equal to cosine alpha cosine beta minus sine alpha sine beta. And if we will to find cosine alpha minus beta, then that will be equal to cosine alpha cosine beta plus sine alpha sine beta. Finally, tangent alpha plus minus beta is equal to tangent alpha plus minus tangent beta all over 1 minus plus tangent alpha tangent beta. Meaning, if we will to find tangent alpha plus beta, then that will be equal to tangent alpha plus tangent beta all over 1 minus tangent alpha tangent beta. And if we will to find tangent alpha minus beta, that will be equal to tangent alpha minus tangent beta all over 1 plus tangent alpha tangent beta. We can actually use the sum and difference identities in finding the exact value of some trigonometric expressions for some given theta, even the theta is not included on our unit circle. Now, we apply the sum and difference identities in finding the exact values of angles, which can be expressed as a sum or difference of two special angles. Hence, we have to recall the values of trigonometric functions of special angles that we have discussed. Let us take some examples. Find the exact value of sine 75. Remember that 75 degrees is not included on our set of special angles on our unit circle. Nonetheless, 75 degrees can be expressed using two special angles on the unit circle. Let 75 degrees be equal to 45 degrees plus 30 degrees, wherein 45 degrees and 30 degrees are both special angles on the unit circle. Using the sum identity for sine function, sine alpha plus beta is equal to sine alpha cosine beta plus cosine alpha sine beta, where alpha is equal to 45 degrees and beta is equal to 30 degrees. Therefore, we will have sine 75 degrees is equal to sine 45 degrees plus 30 degrees. Applying the formula, we will have sine 45 degrees times cosine 30 degrees plus cosine 45 degrees times sine 30 degrees. Remember that we have discussed about the exact values of the trigonometric functions of the special angles in the unit circle. Therefore, we can actually determine the exact values of these four trigonometric expressions here. By substitution, we will have square root of 2 over 2 times square root of 3 over 2 plus square root of 2 over 2 times 1/2. multiplying square root of 2 over 2 and square root of 3 over 2, we will have square root of 6 over 4. And multiplying square root of 2 over 2 and 1 half, we will have square root of 2 over 4. Moreover, adding the two expressions here, notice that we have common denominator. Therefore, we can just simply combine our numerators. However, since they are radicals with different radicands, we cannot combine them as single radical expression. Hence, our final answer would be square root of 6 plus square root of 2 all over 4. Therefore, the value of sine 75 degrees is equal to square root of 6 plus square root of 2 all over 4. Let us try another one. Find the exact value of cosine pi over 12. Let pi over 12 be equal to pi over 3 minus pi over 4. Since pi over 12 is not included in the special angles in the unit circle. However, we can express this angle as a difference of two special angles such as the pi over 3 and pi over 4. Now, using the difference identity for cosine function, cosine alpha minus beta is equal to cosine alpha cosine beta plus sine alpha sine beta, where our alpha is equal to pi over 3 and our beta is equal to pi over 4. Thus, we will have cosine pi over 12 is equal to cosine pi over 3 minus pi over 4. Using the formula above, we will have cosine pi over 3 times cosine pi over 4 plus sine pi over 3 times sine pi over 4. Remember that we have discussed on how to find the exact values of these trigonometric expressions before. Therefore, substituting their exact values, we will have 1 half times square root of 2 over 2 plus square root of 3 over 2 times square root of 2 over 2. Multiplying these and these, we will have square root of 2 over 4 plus square root of 6 over 4. Adding these two rational expressions here with common denominators, we will have the final answer to be square root of 2 plus square root of 6 all over 4. Therefore, this is the exact value of cosine pi over 12. Let us try another one. Find the exact value of tangent 15 degrees. Let 15 degrees be equal to 45 degrees minus 30 degrees. Using the difference identity for tangent function, tangent alpha minus beta is equal to tangent alpha minus tangent beta all over 1 plus tangent alpha times tangent beta, where alpha is equal to 45 degrees and beta is equal to 30 degrees. Thus, we will have tangent 15 degrees is equal to tangent 45 degrees minus tangent 30 degrees all over 1 plus tangent 45 degrees times tangent 30 degrees. Substituting the exact values of these trigonometric expressions here, we will have 1 minus square root of 3 over 3 all over 1 plus 1 times square root of 3 over 3. Subtracting our numerator 1 minus square root of 3 over 3 and simplifying our denominator 1 plus 1 times square root of 3 over 3, we will have the expression 3 minus square root of 3 over 3 all over 3 plus square root of 3 over 3. Dividing these two rational expressions here, we will have 3 minus square root of 3 all over 3 plus square root of 3. Therefore, the exact value of tangent 15 degrees is equal to this value. I hope that you have understood the lesson. For our next video, we will be discussing about simplifying and proving other trigonometric identities using the sum and difference identities. Thank you so much for listening and see you on our next video.